Dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, when we humble ourselves before God's Word, we find true worth for our lives. In the Old Testament lesson, the prophet serves God and finds himself despised by unbelievers. The Old Testament lesson is written in the 11th chapter of Jeremiah, beginning at the 18th verse. Because the Lord revealed their plot to me, I knew it. For at that time, he showed me what they were doing. I had been like a gentle lamb led to the slaughter. I did not realize that they had plotted against me, saying, "Let us destroy the tree and its fruit. Let us cut him off from the land of the living, that his name be remembered no more." But, O Lord Almighty, you who judge righteously and test the heart and mind, let me see your vengeance upon them, for to you I have committed my cause. This is the word of the Lord. James, from his epistle, tells us that God opposes the proud, but gives grace to the humble. The epistle for this, the 18th Sunday after Pentecost, is written in the 3rd chapter of James, beginning at the 16th verse. For where you have envy and selfish ambition, there you find disorder in every evil practice. But the wisdom that comes from heaven is first of all pure, then peace-loving, considerate, submissive, full of mercy and good fruit, impartial and sincere. Peacemakers who sow in peace raise a harvest of righteousness. What causes fights and quarrels among you? Don't they come from your desires that battle within you? You want something but don't get it. You kill and covet, but you cannot have what you want. You quarrel and fight. You do not have because you do not ask God. When you ask, you do not receive because you ask with wrong motives, that you may spend what you get on your pleasures. You adulterous people, don't you know that friendship with the world is hatred toward God? Anyone who chooses to be a friend of the world becomes an enemy of God. Or do you think Scripture says about reason that the Spirit he caused to live in us envies intensely? But he gives us more grace. That is why Scripture says, God opposes the proud, but gives grace to the humble. This is the word of the Lord. Please rise for the reading of the Holy Gospel. In the Holy Gospel, Jesus shows the quarreling disciples what true greatness is. The Holy Gospel is written in the 9th chapter of St. Mark, beginning at the 30th verse. They left that place and passed through Galilee. Jesus did not want anyone to know where they were, because he was teaching his disciples. He said to them, "The Son of Man is going to be betrayed into the hands of men. They will kill him, and after 3 days he will rise." But they did not understand what he meant, and were afraid to ask him about it. They came to Capernaum. When he was in the house, he asked them, "What are you arguing about on the road?" But they kept quiet because on the way they had argued about who was the greatest. Sitting down, Jesus called the 12 and said, "If anyone wants to be first, he must be the very last and the servant of all." He took a little child and had him stand among them. Taking him in his arms, he said to them, "Whoever welcomes one of these little children in my name welcomes me. And whoever welcomes me does not welcome me, but the one who sent me." Here endeth the gospel.